It's time now for Down on the Corner with Dale Hoffman, North Central Arkansas's premier news talk program.
Good morning, North Central Arkansas, South Missouri. It is Monday, July 5th, 2021, 7 a.m.
Yes,
and
sir.
Good morning.
Morning.
Technically, it isn't Monday.
Technically, it isn't Monday.
We're not really here.
We're not really here. This is a figment
of your imagination. I was going to ask you, did you guys have a good time last night at the fireworks?
Oh, yeah. Great time.
It's coming up Sunday. Well, we're pre-recording. We're taking Monday off from the live show. And so at 7:15, 7:20, we're going to rerun a show from June 9th.
Yep.
And talk about Convoy of Hope with Ethan Sara Forhetz.
And so, good information.
Good information. Good folks. Love to have them. And a lot of fun that day.
Yeah.
And so we thought we're going to take Monday off.
Yes,
so
well,
we should.
We're
going to talk a little bit about our fine sponsors and thank them for sponsoring the show. Brood Awakening Coffee, he's been with us for many years, from the radio days now to television.
Yeah.
Brood Awakening Coffee, the best coffee in town. If you're not drinking Brood Awakening, you're just drinking muddy water. I mean, he does a great job. Three locations to serve you, the best coffee in town.
You can feed your face.
More importantly, they have something for everybody. Whether you are a coffee fan or not, that is where you need to stop in the mornings. Like you said, they got cinnamon rolls, scones, they got muffins, they've got...
Keep going.
You name it, they've got it. And let me tell you, it is excellent. Their cinnamon rolls are huge. Their muffins are nice, soft, and fluffy. It is just great. Like I said, they have something for everybody. Whether you're a coffee fan or not, they have you covered. You
and betcha. Icy drinks and...
Yep. And healthy drinks, the whole nine yards. You know, Brood Awakening Coffee, the best coffee in town. Mike and the staff do a great job at all three locations. Be sure to check them out tomorrow after the holiday.
Local business.
Oh, there you go.
Local business.
Great business. He's done a great job. Roller Funerals of Arkansas, bring the morning prayer each and every day with all our respect. Roller Funeral Homes, 29 in the state of Arkansas to serve you, one in Memphis, Tennessee. The Roller Funeral Home family has been with us for a long time. Appreciate their sponsorship for the morning prayer. And very talented people to be able to do what they do and do it so well, and to treat each other, to treat their people with such respect.
Well, they have that dedication.
They do.
Is what it is.
They're outstanding.
You're called for that job.
You don't decide.
Right. Yeah. You know.
Yeah. I tell people, you want to know the difference, Roller Funeral Home, go over and talk to one of them.
Go talk to them, yeah.
You'll quickly figure out where their passion is and where their heart is.
And you see, with all respect on the screen, it's not just a graphic that we've dreamed up. That's how they do business on
a daily basis. And for all the funeral homes that are here, I mean, they all do a good job. Roller does a great job. I mean, the facility is great and everything else. But just all those that are called to that, and God bless them. Because they take people through a very...
Yep.
Obviously, the most traumatic thing that can happen to you,
that's right.
The death of a loved one. And be prepared, get ahead of it, get in there, get pre-planned, go over what your will, make sure everything is up to snuff, make sure you've got power of attorney for real estate, as well as having your, as part of having your affairs in order. And help the kids out. You know, pick out what it is you want to wear. My mom's got her songs picked out.
Oh, really?
She's got it. She's got everything, and she's had it. I mean, it wasn't, you know, because she sees people that have had trauma, and to see what the kids go through and to try to adjust. So you can help everybody out by doing that.
Roller Funerals, with all respect, let's pause now for our morning prayer. Heavenly Father, as we celebrate our nation's independence, let us not forget the price paid for our rights and freedoms for over 200 years. Many men and women have died to ensure we remain a free people. And today I pray for our young people and pray that they realize and know the sacrifice made by many people that allows them to do whatever they want to do. I pray you bless our veterans and their families, and for those lost in battle, let their memory live forever. Lord, we are grateful for this nation, and I pray we'll return to godly values and morals. Thank you for blessing the United States of America, and I pray we are worthy of your blessings. It's my prayer today. Amen.
Amen.
Roller Funeral Homes of Arkansas, bring the morning prayer each and every day with all our respect, Roller Funeral Homes. And because we are recording, we're not going to do a live weather, and I want to thank Bob and Linda, the Z Team, for sponsoring our weather each and every day. And we normally
Bob did say, though, because it's a special event,
that he wanted to do a trumpet
sound. To see if he could compete with some of the professionals.
I said that was the other Bob.
Oh, that was the other Bob.
That was the other Bob.
Yeah.
Who said that and then left.
Wait till this plays back on.
He won't know. He'll be sleeping. It's a holiday for him, too.
So anyway, I want to thank the Z-Team, the award-winning Z-Team. Bob and Linda Zdora, you can call them at 870-405-0793. Website's retiretoarkansas.net. Be sure to check out the live webcam and all the listings with the MLS listings in the Century 21 MLS area. And we're going to do an abbreviated this week.
I do want to bring this up before he actually gets into talking real quick, because you're talking about the live webcam. Let me tell you, it's 4th of July. That is one of the best places to watch fireworks. Oh, yeah. So anytime you guys get a chance, go on there.
Wow. Yeah. I mean,
and the thunderstorms the other night.
That was just gorgeous.
Spectacular.
Yeah. So. All right, thank you for sponsoring our weather. We love the webcam, and I'll take pictures of it, send it to people around the country, and say, hey, take a look at where we are.
We appreciate that, because it is a good, I mean, it's a nice piece to add of part of the things that we do, and to bring people to the website where they can find real estate information, where they can help expand their search when they're trying to figure out where it is they want to go, what they want to do, whether buying or selling. I mean, you can see what we do for our clients that others may not. And that's an important decision. If you're going to list your home, you're going to sell your home, you want to make sure that whoever is helping you knows what they're doing. And that just really can't be overstated. We're certified buyers. We're senior real estate specialists. We're graduates of the Realtor Institute, which is actually a pretty big deal. And Sam and I are military relocation professionals. All of those are designations from the National Association of Realtors, and just things that we do above and beyond just taking the normal class that you have to take every year, the continuing ed class. We continue to strive to improve our skills. We've been doing this for a long time. We pretty much know what we're doing. We do, but there's always something new that comes up. There's always a different class that you can take, a different place that you can visit on the web and learn how to do your job better, learn what's current and current practices and how things have changed. And that's an important thing to know, because you're helping people make through a time that can be very stressful. I mean, short of the loved one that we spoke about before, buying and selling a home can be, it's right up there as far as stress and things, not knowing what's going on and what's going to work for me and what's not going to work for me. And we are very good at helping people to do that. So we spend time, and the team has done a great job. We're licensed in, Linda and Darlene are licensed in Missouri. And Reese has got that southern corridor covered, Calico, all the way down to Mountain View.
Boy, he knows
He knows. Well, he's born and raised. I mean, he does know it. He's been on those back roads. So we do This Week in Real Estate, and we've been doing it for a while as a service for people so that they have a better idea of what's going on. The first thing, we'll stop someplace and somebody will see me and say, well, how's the real estate market? Well, the idea of This Week in Real Estate is to give people an idea of what the real estate market is like. So we've been doing it for a while, pal.
We have.
Different venues. So we'll hit the numbers, so we'll see how we do for time here.
That sounds good, yeah.
So This Week in Real Estate, there were 53 new listings came on, one commercial property, 18 parcels of land, 33 homes came on. They came on in a range from $650,000 to $24,000. Of those 33 homes that are on the market, 9 of them are taking backups already. Average price coming on the market was $216,000. There were 54 sales this past week, 2 commercial properties, 20 parcels of land, 32 homes sold. Those homes sold in a range from $589,000 to $42,000. Average sale price of $234,000 with 66 days on market. So the time on market, people are coming here buying. So if you're selling, you need to be ready.
There's too much.
Well, we'll put it up and we'll see what happens, because you don't know what's going to happen, and they want to move in 30 days. $7.5 million in residential real estate closed this past week. 11 properties expired, 13 have price changes. There's 104 pendings. We're at 144 homes listed on the MLS, so we're up 14. So the number's creeping up a little bit, and that's a good thing. Give people more to look at. Year to date, there's been 606 homes have sold for $117 million. Average time on market is 95 days. Average sale price of $193,000. In the first 6 months of this year, all real estate, from farms and commercial, everything, there's been 945 sales.
945.
For $147.9 million. So it's busy. And it's busy at the banks. It's busy at the closing companies. It's busy at everybody involved in real estate has been here to help people in different things. Last year, there had been 511 homes that sold for $81.8 million, 141 days on market, an average sale price of $160 compared to $193 this year. And then in 19, because with the COVID, we were in the middle of COVID this year when as far as people coming down. In 19, there had been 535 homes that sold for $78.3 million, 135 days on market, an average sale price of $146. So you can see how the market has moved forward. In this time, so in like I say, I can't overstress the importance of being ready if you're buying or selling. Because if you're selling, you're going to be going someplace else, and you need to be pre-approved there. You need to know what it is you're looking at there. You need to. Century 21 has a great, great referral system, and we can take and get you set up with an agent in that market that knows that market, and you're not just going there cold and cold calling real estate companies and not knowing what you get. Linda and I, because of the designations that we have, because of the our position within Century 21, we have back of the house stuff. And, you know, so we know what agents have won what awards. We know that this a senior real estate specialist, somebody who's a certified buyer's rep who can help you make a good decision, go into that market, because we're not the only one where the market's kind of tight right now. Most other big markets are the same way. So you want to be ready and to have somebody in your corner going in beforehand, before we've done this with people before we even put the house on the market. We had them set up with an agent there. They got out. They took a look at the new area that they're going to go to. Some people realized that it's exactly what we had wanted. Other people hadn't been to that area before. We're going to go to Florida. Okay, you're going to have to do better than that because you're just going to be like a wandering tribe down in Florida. So by picking an area, picking an agent that knows that area and being able to help get you there successfully and as easily as we can. That's the whole purpose. We want to make this as easy as we can.
Of course, Bob and Linda Zdora, the Z Team, for all your real estate needs, 870-405-0793, retiretoarkansas.net.
Yes, sir.
While our visitors are here, we need to welcome them. And if you're thinking of moving to the Twin Lakes area, these are the people you need to be talking to because they can get it done now.
Yeah, and if you go to the office, ask for the Z Team. We don't own Century 21. We're proud employees there. We're all independent contractors. The Z Team does not own Century 21 because I've had people say, oh, yeah, we listed with you. No, you didn't. You listed with Jewel. That's great. That was a great job. We're so appreciative of her. But you want to? If you call the office, ask for the Z Team. If you stop by, ask for the Z Team.
And real quick, I want to plug the Z Team because they're a transplant. I moved from St. Louis 49 years ago. Y'all been down here about 25 years or so.
18-ish.
Y'all from Northern Illinois.
Yeah.
And appreciate y'all coming in and joining the fun. And this is
home.
How can we help?
This is home. That's
active
right.
At St. Peter's the Fishman Catholic Church, where you still usher.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yeah. I usher at 8:30. Yeah.
Yep. That's good. And all the charity events
and the
that
different
you
things, you know, I help with the I'm a vice president of the Twin Lakes Retired Police Scholarship Foundation. We raise money for scholarships for local law enforcement, for their kids, for secondary education. Just try to coppers got together and try to do something
That's
to help
great.
Our brothers and sisters out, because these guys don't make any money here. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, especially for the work that they do. You don't know how blessed you are to have the police that you have here.
Oh, yeah.
So, so that's one of the things that we do to try to help with that. And this is home. It's
and
where we want to be.
Thank you for your service to the United States as a Marine.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. And for all your real estate needs, call the Z Team, 870-405-0793, retiretoarkansas.net. Doesn't matter where you live now. If you want to live here, call the Z Team. They'll get it done.
That's right. That's right.
So you got 25 seconds. Final thought.
Just give my honey a call. She spins the plates. I tell you to call me, but I'm going to tell you to call her anyway because she's the one who makes all the appointments and everything else. So that's the important part. I can't. She's my girl.
Once again, this is a pre-recorded intro. I hope you enjoy the show coming up with Ethan and Sara
Forhetz
of Convoy of Hope. Great folks, great ministry, and we will see you live on Tuesday.
It's a matter of taste, and at Brick Oven Pizza Company in Mountain Home, delicious taste is all you will find. Enjoy signature crafted pizzas and appetizers, as well as oven-baked sandwiches, quesadillas, salads, pastas, and desserts. When it comes time to relax or meet up with friends, Brick Oven Pizza has you covered. Handmade cocktails and ice-cold beer are always available at their fully stocked bar. No time to dine in? No problem. Call in your order and use Brick Oven's convenient drive-thru window for all your to-go orders. It's a matter of taste at Brick Oven Pizza Company in Mountain Home. Get the only mower with suspension technology at Mower Warehouse in Mountain Home, where they accept mower trade-ins, have flexible financing options, and services all brands and models. That's Mower Warehouse, located on Buzzard Roost in Mountain Home.
When I grow up, I want to save lives, like a superhero, and show up when people needed me.
When I grow up, I want to do animations. I want to create characters that can fly.
No matter what it is you want out of life, there is a path to get there.
When I grow up, I don't know what I want to do when I grow up, but I know I want to go to college.
Arkansas State University, Mountain Home. Take your first step at asumh.edu.
Hi, it's Bob Zdora, the Z Team, Century 21 LeMac Realty, 1024 Highway 62 East in Mountain Home. As you know, we are all facing some unusual times. Be calm. Be smart. The business world of real estate will continue. We may have some delays and some changes that are out of our control, but life will go on, and this too will pass. Give thanks for this wonderful country that we live in. Give thanks for the neighbors that we share. If there's anything we can do to give you a hand, give us a call, 870-405-0793.
And check out our website, retiredtoarkansas.net.
Have you ever noticed every time you wash your car, you end up wetter than the actual car? Next time, run down to Car Care and let the friendly staff put a smile on your face. Car Care of Mountain Home has a variety of services to clean your vehicle's needs, inside and out. From a simple wash and shine to their outstanding detail services. Located 1525 Highway 62 East in Mountain Home. Stop by Car Care in Mountain Home today, because driving a clean car always makes you feel good.
So there I was, naked as a jaybird in the shower with soap in my hair and eyes, when I lost water pressure down to a dribble. I immediately grabbed my towel and dialed up Jake at JM Sales and Pump Service. Jake came right over and fixed my water pressure. Now I can take my showers with confidence. Just call Jake.
For all your sales and pump needs, just call Jake at JM Sales and Pump Service, 870-431-5445. He offers high-quality, stay-right products.
At Connor Family Funeral Home, our goal is to provide our friends and neighbors with caring, compassionate services at an affordable price. Connor Family is a full-service funeral home that offers a wide range of services to meet your family's needs and customs. We are the first on-site crematory in the area and provide many options to memorialize your loved ones and address all the details for a more personalized service. Where compassion and affordability meet, Connor Family Funeral Home in Mountain Home.
Take a step back in time when going to a barbershop meant more than just getting a haircut. Come into Legionnaire Barbershop today, a unique gentleman's barbershop. Get back in style with two experienced licensed barbers who are trained in tonsorial arts and lock removal and are happy to give you a straight razor shave. Legionnaire Barbershop is veteran owned and operated and located at 1041 Highland Circle, Suite 55 in Mountain Home. For a full, old-fashioned barbershop experience, stop by Legionnaire Barbershop today.
When you think about Hospice of the Ozarks, it's our desire that you think about finding a way to live your life to the fullest while living with a serious illness. If you ever need help and support, we provide a team of healthcare professionals and volunteers that will support your physical, emotional, and spiritual aspects of life while doing the same for your family and caregivers in the comfort of your own home or wherever you call home. When you think about Hospice of the Ozarks, we hope that you grant us permission to walk on the journey with you. Your not-for-profit option since 1979.
When you're .719, and I couldn't be more thrilled to have these two folks on the TV program this morning, Ethan and Sara Forhetz of Convoy of Hope, formerly with KY3 News in Springfield, and I think some of the two most recognizable names in the four-state area, Oklahoma, Kansas, Missouri, and Arkansas. And how many times, I've been watching KY3 News since 1972, so yeah. I've seen
wow.
it probably.
Right.
Seen,
I believe it.
I remember a young Ned Reynolds.
I'm not sure that ever existed.
I was gonna, yeah, I don't know about that. Get a fact checker in here.
But what a thrill and an honor. And now they've stepped out on faith and now with Convoy of Hope. And what Convoy of Hope does around the world, not only in the Springfield-based area and in the nation, but, you know, tornadoes, hurricanes, whatever, the Convoy of Hope trucks are running.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, just yesterday we got a proclamation from the city of Houston, Texas. It was super cool. We were on a digital feed with them. They made a Convoy of Hope Day in Houston, Texas, just to thank us for what we did during their winter storm. They had a very severe, extreme winter storm, and the power was out, which meant the water wasn't working for a lot of folks. So we supplied them with more than 3 million bottles of water during that, and they were just very appreciative. So that was just one of the things we've done here recently, but we're honored to work at a place like Convoy of Hope.
Well, I would be too. And isn't that based through the Assembly of God Churches that's based in Springfield? Is that a ministry of or a mission of?
It's a partner with, but it's not tied to any denomination.
Oh, really?
I think a lot of people think that it is an AG offshoot,
right.
but it's not. I mean, we partner with them because they're right down the block from us.
Yeah.
But we partner with all churches. Any church that that wants to work with us, we're happy to be part of it.
You know, I've been Southern Baptist all my life, and I think Southern Baptist Convention along with Convoy of Hope, and I think Red Cross, and there's another one, I think maybe Salvation Army, I think Convoy goes out first.
Convoy often goes out first. I feel like we have good relationships with people. That's one thing I've learned is they are super relational.
Yeah.
Even in the office, which has been funny because coming from news, we are running and gunning. And they will take time to talk and get to know each other and really, but that translates into the field because we will be invited in by municipalities and county governments and because they just like the way that Convoy does business. So it's been a neat thing to watch. We're Christian people, so to see what the Bible says about relationships and then to see them act in relationship is just cool.
Mm. And what's great about Convoy of Hope that we're learning is that we have an army out there all across the country and even in other countries, and that is churches that we partner with. Like Sara said, we will wait to be called in and asked to come help with the disaster. We just don't show up because sometimes you show up and they don't need you or want you. So we wait. We want to be good stewards of the resources we have. So if there's a need for it and they ask us to come in and help, then we're, in most of the time, happy and able to do that. But the army of churches on the ground really makes Convoy, I think, unique in that we can partner with a church, and then the church handles a lot of the distribution. They've got an army of volunteers that all they have to do is make a phone call to, and those people are willing to show up and be part of the distribution because they're taking the resources that we give them and give them to their neighbors. So it's really a great system the Convoy has. The infrastructure is built in, and it's using the volunteer help through churches, which already have the volunteers built in.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
How did it get, what's the history behind Convoy of Hope? I mean,
it started in 1994 by the Donaldson family. Hal Donaldson and his brothers started it. And it's got a great way that it started because Hal Donaldson was a college kid, and he went away to India to work after college. He was a journalist, and he was writing a book, and part of that book was going to India to interview Mother Teresa, which is a very cool thing to do,
sure,
right? So he's talking to Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa changed his life with a question. She said, "What are you doing to help the poor?" And that hit him deep, and he didn't want to lie to Mother Teresa because that's not a good thing.
No, I think no chances there.
You don't want to lie to Mother Teresa.
No.
So he gave an honest answer, and Hal Donaldson, the president and founder of Convoy of Hope, said, "Well, nothing." And she said, "You may not be able to do everything, but you can do something." And he took that to heart and went home and prayed about it, read the Bible and found out that's what the Bible says to do.
Sure, yeah.
And said, "Okay, I'm going to do something." So they started Convoy of Hope with just handing out groceries out of the back of a pickup truck. That's where it started in California. They moved to Springfield, and it has grown incredibly over the last several years. We now have the convoy of trucks that go out that are known around the country and around the world, and it's really an incredible organization.
I thought it was neat. Yesterday we had lunch with someone who's been there for 20 years or something, and he was saying he's done everything in the building, including cleaning the toilets. Because now he's kind of a higher, I don't even know what his title is, honestly, but he's a higher up, you know? Mm-hmm. And just to think that when something starts, you know, out of the back of a pickup truck or out of your garage, what it is today, you know, it's an amazing thing to say, I've literally cleaned the toilets for Convoy and now I'm a higher up. But fortunately, now there's a different crew to do multiple different jobs. You know, you don't have to wear so many hats, but the humility is honestly... is instructive, I feel like, for my own life.
Wow, what a story.
That's great. I don't know. Please, just
keep going. So you've been around the world teaching. Last
trip was in Tanzania.
Tanzania,
yeah.
Okay. Weren't you in Israel not too long ago?
And we were in Israel,
a couple years ago. 2 years ago, right? Yeah, 2 years ago, last month.
We're supposed to be there right now.
We're supposed to be right now.
Literally, we should be there today. But with COVID and then the unrest, the tour group moved it back. So, by the way, if you want to go to Israel in 2022, we are going May 29th, right? May 29th through June 9th. You should come, Dale. It would be great.
Yeah, we're kind of leading a tour over there, and Sarah's going to be speaking at a lot of sites, so it's going to be it was a life-changing trip. I mean, to see the Bible literally come to life before your eyes and to be in the places that you've read about your entire life is really a life-changing thing. I would advise any Christian to make a trip to Israel. The earlier the better, so that you can get more out of it for the rest of your life.
And this is next, what?
2022. So, yeah, May, the end of May and through June 9th of 2022. It's $4,400, and that is all-inclusive. That's airline,
that's a good price.
Hotels. By the grace of God, they're giving us our pre-COVID pricing. Because we were nervous that they were going to really kick up the price because a bunch of the other trips on their website have gone way up. But because we were already scheduled, they're giving us that.
Well, that's incredible.
I know, it
so
is.
So it's the price from 2 years ago because we were supposed to go.
2 years ago.
In
yeah.
20, yeah.
Right. What else? What Ethan was talking about with it coming to life. We went to the Valley of Elah, which is where David fought Goliath. And, wow. You know, when you're reading the story, you can read over certain phrases and it not really mean anything to you. I mean, you're understanding the meaning just on the surface, but when it says that he went down to the valley or up over or through, or I mean, to see it geographically and to understand that every single word actually is accurate.
Provable,
which,
yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know it's accurate because you know the Bible is accurate, but then to see the proof, you know, such as, oh, he went down, literally down a hill, up a hill, through a valley, over,
and
you know,
there.
It's not very far.
I mean, there's a hill here and there's a hill here. Then there's a valley in the middle and there's the stream where the pebbles came from.
Right.
Yeah,
and then
does that put chills up your back?
Oh, yeah. The whole time. Because, you know, when they were talking to each other, you think, well, how can they hear each other in this big valley? But then to understand that when you're in a valley, there is a certain acoustics where, you know, Scooter's sitting way over there and you feel like you're talking to him this close. I mean, it's truly incredible. We were blown away.
Mm. You know, my dad was in the space program. My dad worked, we're basically from the, I grew up in Fairview Heights.
You mentioned Collinsville earlier and Sarah looked at me and said, hey, you got a shout out.
I knew where you were from. That's right.
It's the horseradish capital of the world, as you know.
Do what?
It's the horseradish capital of the world.
Yeah. And the ketchup bottle there.
That's right, the world's
largest ketchup bottle. Is it still in Collinsville?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Is it?
Oh, absolutely.
Ethan's claim to fame.
Is the ketchup bottle.
The Brooks ketchup bottle. That's right.
You know what I found the other day? My uncle gave me a schedule, 1959, 1960 Belleville Maroons.
Oh, yeah.
Basketball schedule. So I put on a group of Fairview Heights friends.
Yeah.
And I've got that long poster, and he's got one loss. And it's so cool to see
everybody
like Springfield Catholic. And we played East St. Louis in those days.
Right. Well, they're in the same conference now, still.
Is it safe in East St. Louis?
Well, yeah. Yeah, you can get the games.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. I haven't been downtown. I used to, when my grandfather was Terminal Railroad in St. Louis, and he'd come pick me up before I started first grade in 64. He'd come, "Mom, I'm going to pick up the paycheck, Dale, and right along." So we go over to St. Louis, and we walk all across these railroad tracks. Terminal was a hub. And so he'd find one of his buddies, "Hey, where are you going?" "Well, we're going east across these. You're going to stop at 25th and Missouri Avenue, East St. Louis." I'd get on the engine right under Eads Bridge across the river,
wow,
drive at 25th and Missouri Avenue, and get in my grandfather's 55 Plymouth and go home.
Oh, wow.
That is crazy.
That really is incredible.
You're too young for that, Dale.
Really?
You're too kind, Sarah.
My parents grew up in East St. Louis. Yeah, that's where they grew up. It was a wonderful city.
By the church that they went to,
mm-hmm,
long time ago.
Yeah.
Really? That's my birthplace, East St. Louis. That's birth certificate.
There you go.
Yeah.
My mom's
but anyway,
too.
My dad was in space program, and they worked directly with Jet Propulsion Laboratory and a place in Gifu, Japan. He was Mercury and Gemini in St. Louis, McDonnell Douglas Aircraft.
Yeah, yeah.
And this report came out, and what they had to do, you know, Gemini and Mercury were the prerequisites to Apollo. But to get the timing right, because you've got the Earth going around the sun and the moon going around the Earth, so they made a computer program to reverse it, to track it.
Okay.
They missed a day. Guess where they found it?
Is that right?
It's either, remember where the day stopped? What is that, in Amos or Joshua?
Oh, wow.
Yes.
They found it.
Wow.
They found
it. Is that right?
That's the only explanation.
That's incredible.
That's the only.
That is incredible.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
And I remember it was like 1965 or 1966. This is about the Mercury Gemini era. Yeah. And, you know, of course, the timing, you know, when Apollo 11 actually landed on the moon, they had 10 seconds worth of fuel programmed to set down. Another 10 seconds, they would have been short on fuel to make the ascent back up.
It's incredible.
Wow.
That's how close it was. But that's how close that timing was.
Wow.
That's amazing.
And to do that back then with, the computer really, that you have on your watch now.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
So that's what's wild. Man,
you know,
technology.
And the computer memory on the big
still
reels of tape. You know, it's amazing what they pulled off.
It
but
really is.
But that lost day is right there. And I forget, it's either in Amos or Joshua. I'd have to look it back up.
Where the sun stands still?
Yep, that's
yeah,
it.
It's
yeah,
amazing.
We're going to take a break. Come up with 7:32 more with Ethan and Sarah Forrest of Convoy of Hope right after this. When you're out of town, make sure your pet is with someone who will love them as much as you do. At 201 Pet Salon and Resort, your pet is cared for just as they would be at home. 201 Pet Salon and Resort is the only all-suite climate-controlled and air-filtered boarding facility in the area with private and spacious rooms to keep your pet relaxed. And with over 3/4 acre of fence play area, your pet will receive the proper exercise they deserve. 201 also offers professional grooming services. Your best friend is in good hands at 201 Pet Salon and Resort in Mountain Home.
At Letty's Mexican Restaurant, we're here to keep you safe during these difficult times, as well as serve you the best Mexican food in the area. That's why we've installed a convenient pickup window for all your to-go and pickup orders, as well as a covered outdoor seating area. Give us a call at 870-435-2532 to order your next meal. And don't forget, Letty's also provides catering for small parties or big events. Experience the best in Mexican cuisine. Letty's in Gasville.
Jim Brown Company keeps you cool when it's hot and warm when it's not. A trusted name in the Mountain Home community, Jim Brown Company provides timely heating and cooling installation and repairs. Our certified technicians incorporate new technology on every job to provide you with the most advanced services. At our metal fabrication shop, we handle projects big and small. We've created everything from commercial ducts to custom designs.
I'd recommend Jim Brown Company to my friends and neighbors. The reason being, they have high-tech equipment, their service techs are well qualified for the job that they do, and they also send me a report after all the work is done, so I know exactly what my unit's doing.
By visiting our showroom, you can learn all about our heating and cooling products. We'll educate you on your options and help you decide on the right solution. For total comfort at your home or business, choose Jim Brown Company, quality service with a family name since 1964.
Hi, I'm Benny with Ammo Dump.
At Ammo Dump, they carry new and used firearms, large supply of shotguns, rifles, and handguns. Ammo Dump will buy, sell, or trade in your item and can special order whatever you like. They also have knives, scopes, ammo of any caliber, and provide gun cleaning and restoration. Call them today for the best competitive pricing around.
If I don't have it or can't get it because I don't make it, come and see us.
That's Ammo Dump, located next to Woodman's Package in Norfolk.
Almost 7:35, we're visiting with Ethan Sara Forhetz of Convoy of Hope. How can we get churches in North Arkansas affiliated and help more with Convoy? What y'all are doing is incredible. I mean, I don't care if it's California, Maine, Florida, Texas, Arkansas, whatever, Illinois. How can we help? I know money's in, I mean, let's raise some money too.
Yeah, money's the best way. I mean, we always need volunteers and we need church partners so that when we come to do a community event, a giveaway, that sort of thing, we have that infrastructure, the army of people volunteering that I was talking about earlier. But, you know, money is the best way. If you're going to give something tangible, money's the best thing because we have partners, corporate partners that we deal with who are able to take that money and make it go five times further than you could right. If you were going to the store to buy bottled water. Right, we have the ability to work with them, and they donate some, and they give us deals on other things, so we can make the dollar stretch a lot further than an individual could.
And also, I was recently in Iberia, Missouri, yeah. Tiny town, and it was very interesting because we've been around Convoy, if you will, just from KY3 covering it. But I never knew about this program they have called Rural Compassion. And what they do is they equip, you know, sports coaches or church leaders or the health department or the fire chief with product because they believe that help is needed by people who Convoy might not ever be aware of. But the local church or the local sports coach or the local health department worker or, you know, Head Start, OCAC, those types of people. So they supply the product to those rural communities and then it allows the rural communities to literally be able to show up on people's doorstep with a bag of groceries and say, hey, you might not ever come to a church. You might not ever come to an outreach. But we will come to you because we know, you know, from little Johnny at school.
Right, it's targeted.
It's very targeted. And I thought that is the coolest thing because that day I was meeting a bunch of community leaders, some of them from churches, many of them not from churches. But one of the men who I interviewed was a Christian pastor, and he said, you know, I always felt like my church was inside my four walls. Now, he understands that the body of Christ is outside the church building.
Right.
But he said, to see that my congregation is not the people in my pews. My congregation is my whole town. I'm called to shepherd my whole town. And I've never been able to show up with a gift. Well, the book of Proverbs talks about a gift opens the door for that relationship that we were talking about. And it's just cool to watch him be able to go to people's houses with something tangible to give them, which starts a relationship. And I never knew Convoy did that, you know, but they do that in rural communities all across the country. So it's cool because I got to see it in action in Missouri. But I mean, that is, you know, small town Arkansas. I mean, just around Mountain Home. I mean, how many tiny little towns?
Oh, yeah. I mean, just between here in the state line, we're only 15 miles as a crow flies, right. 5201 and 101 highways, you know. And, you know, you get back on the little country county roads. Yeah.
And I think you'd be surprised because we were, when we started a Convoy, about how much they do locally because you don't hear much about that. Even us, when we were on the news, we didn't know about everything Convoy was doing locally in the Springfield area and here because they don't do it. They don't brag about it. They're really good
they
about
just do it
humility.
And, yeah.
I mean, that's very important to them. So they don't brag about it. We, as spokespeople, say, well, we need to talk about it a little bit more so people know that we do it.
Sure.
So we're that's what I'm doing
people
right now.
We're here.
That's all right.
Yeah, but that's true.
But we supply a lot of the food, a lot of the product that the food pantries then give out. So,
really?
Yeah,
I didn't know that.
We have the product. So a lot of the food pantries will either send a truck to them or they'll come with a truck up to our world distribution center and pick up a load of supply, take back to the food pantry to then give out to who needs it in the local areas. That happens every day.
So the main office is in Springfield.
Yes.
And are there satellites in other places, or do you go from here if there's an incident that you're going to go respond to?
Yeah, we have warehouses, few warehouses throughout.
So you get stuff pre-staged.
Yes.
Right.
Like, for instance, whenever the tornadoes happened down in Alabama and Georgia fairly recently, we had in Macon, Georgia, we have a warehouse from which that truck left before the truck from Springfield left and got there much earlier and was on the ground able to tell the trucks with all the big trucks with all the supply where they needed to go, which was the best places to be.
You can't go down this way, go that way.
Correct. And this area, you've heard about this area on the news, but this area is actually worse. Let's go here. There's more of a need. So yeah, we have some warehouses, not many, but in different parts of the country, some strategically placed warehouses. Yeah, because you know the Georgia area. That's down in the south where the tornado, or not the tornadoes, sometimes tornadoes, but the hurricanes come in, and from there we can get to places quickly.
Okay, is it mostly food, water, things, or do you do shelter? Do you have tents? Do you do?
We don't have, we have some shelters. Most of it is food and water.
Okay.
Cleaning supplies, because you know, often when a tornado goes through, you'd be amazed of the things that we find out that people need that we say, okay, we need to supply. Those plastic totes. That they can put a lid on that's waterproof, so that as they're sifting through what's left, they have a place to put it, and they can put it in the back of a truck, and then move on with their lives slowly but surely.
When the Joplin tornado came through, my son was in a youth group at one of the churches, and this was about 7 or 8 days after the devastation, and they were having dinner somewhere around, I think they went on up maybe to Springfield. But he says, Dad, you can see it on TV, but just to stand here and look 5, 10, however many days, he says, it's just unreal. In a disaster like that, I mean, that is the tornado of the century, really, in Joplin. That was like an F5, 1.3 miles wide. I mean,
the deadliest in history, single tornado.
Where do you start?
Oh, well, you start by the immediate need, which is giving people what they need in the moment, water. Food as they're sifting through their belongings. We sent crews to help them sift through. We sent crews with chainsaws to take down the trees. But it is overwhelming because we were both there the day after, and we had never seen anything like it.
I think you were stationed at the hospital.
Yes.
During the newscast.
That's right.
And I was going all over the place. I did dozens of stories every single day. So I was driving all over. I mean, but, you know, navigation was, it's interesting because I'm like, how did I even meet up with people? I mean, I can remember getting in touch with people and finding them, but looking back at the video, because we just had the 10-year anniversary, I'm like, how did I find these people? You know, like, how did we connect? Because the street signs were gone. You know, many of the thoroughfares were covered. I don't even know how we did that, but we sure did.
It's weird because we went back and we did a whole half an hour for Convoy in-house, just about, because it really grew Convoy. Convoy kind of got a national name in that disaster because of the work that we did. And we built 13 houses following that for people who needed them. So it really kind of changed the way Convoy did things. And the recognition that Convoy now gets nationally, but while we were there, it was I tried to recollect in my mind and recreate the images that I saw, but I couldn't do it to the detail because the detail was so intense. Of every single thing was twisted in some way and thrown and in piles that you wouldn't expect, cars and trees. It was unbelievable. And I just, as we were putting that half hour together for Convoy, looking at all the video kind of brought it back. But we went back there and we did some interviews back in what it looks like now. And it's striking the difference because everything's fairly new within the last 10 years. And all of the trees, there are no tall trees in that area, which was a neighborhood. The main part of town was very old trees, established trees and established houses, all gone and all new now.
The interesting, I interviewed a man who Convoy of Hope helped right after the storm. He was actually in Pierce City because, you know, the Joplin tornado, we think of Joplin, but it was, as you said, mile, you know, 1.3 mile swath.
Wide, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that was the width. Yeah. So anyway, we were interviewing him and he said that he was outside trying to get his farm cleaned up. He's a blueberry farmer. And a man stops by his driveway and says, "Hey, could you use some help?" And he said, "Yeah, I have 80 oak trees down on my livelihood," which is this blueberry farm. And the man said, "Okay," and drove off. And the gentleman I was interviewing was like, "Yeah, I didn't know what he was going to bring to the table," so to speak. And he partnered with a church in Arkansas. That gentleman, who is part of Convoy, has a relationship with a church in Arkansas. And he brought like 50 people back to this man's house the next day. They show up that morning. They cut up into firewood 80 oak trees. And then they said, "Well, your blueberries, we need to replant your blueberries. This is your livelihood." And he was like, "Well, it's not the time to put the seed in the ground, you know?" And so they, you know, set their schedule. They came back months down the road.
You're kidding.
Same team. Sorry. Months down the road came back and helped him plant. And he said that he had the most fruitful crop. He had never done it that well himself as he did whenever. And I thought, that is, in my mind, the definition of Convoy of Hope. I mean, they are there for the long haul in the sense that when you're partnering mainly with a local church, and they do partner with municipalities and governments. Sure. I mean, honestly, God's given them favor around the world with, you know, governments that you would not think would be friendly, so to speak. Yet the doors that only God can open. But to see, you know, at least in America, when they're partnering with local churches, it's like, because you as a Christian, it's not, I mean, yes, you're representing Convoy, but more than that, you're an extension of the Heavenly Father.
Yes.
And you're saying, "I don't care what the season is, I'm going to come back and help you whenever it's time to put seed in the ground." You know,
yeah.
It was just cool.
I think we know that your help isn't over. You need more help,
right?
Not just today, but you need it then as well.
Yeah, sustainability is
That's huge.
It's huge.
Huge for people.
It
because they were like, "Well, yeah, they were here and they helped, and then everybody disappeared, and I'm still here with my mess."
That's one of the things that I think has impressed us the most as we learn more about Convoy, being there every day, is that everything is built to be sustainable. You know, eventually, we feed 387,000 kids every school day around the world.
Whoa, whoa, say that again now.
300, and this is a new number from last year, and it's the biggest ever. And during a COVID year, 387,000 children are fed by Convoy of Hope every school day.
Wow.
Which is a staggering number. If you think
it really
about
is.
That's a lot of food, and it's a lot of influence in their lives, and it really changes not only their lives, but their families' lives. Because we do, and you can go to convoyofhope.org, and there's a news and stories page where we post all our stories, just about the things we're doing if you're interested.
Okay.
We have a story about a young man named Chege, and he grew up, his mother passed away, and his father was an abusive drunk, actually beat his mother to death. And he grew up as an orphan, basically, went to school and didn't know where his meals were coming from. So he did terribly in school because all he could think about was his empty stomach and where he was going to get food. Convoy of Hope moved into that school. He started getting three meals a day at school taken care of. And he had been failed three times in class. He quickly jumped back up to his grade level and surpassed that. And the story is now he's in college becoming a teacher because he wanted to go back and bless the kids like the teacher who blessed him. It's an incredible story. But you were talking about how do people get involved, churches especially. You can give us a call at Convoy of Hope. We'd be happy to partner with you and to talk about a relationship. And for churches, we do certain things. Like we put stories together that churches can air on Sunday mornings if they want.
Really?
To kind of update people on where their money is going and how Convoy of Hope is using it, especially during times of disaster. We're working in India now with COVID and that sort of thing. And it's disaster season starting up. So
yeah.
It's sadly a matter of time before our trucks are going to be rolling.
Mm. With that, final break, 7:49, more with Ethan and Sarah right after this.
Diatley Dental Care is a family-owned dental practice. Doctors Irvin and Christina Diatley grew up in the Twin Lakes area and are proud to serve the community. With modern treatment methods and state-of-the-art technology, they are dedicated to providing exemplary care to patients of all ages. Our compassionate team consistently receives training above and beyond the standard of care.
We're changing the way you see dentistry.
Come be a part of our dental family.
It's a matter of taste, and at Brick Oven Pizza Company in Mountain Home, delicious taste is all you will find. Enjoy signature crafted pizzas and appetizers, as well as oven-baked sandwiches, quesadillas, salads, pastas, and desserts. When it comes time to relax or meet up with friends, Brick Oven Pizza has you covered. Handmade cocktails and ice-cold beer are always available at their fully stocked bar. No time to dine in? No problem. Call in your order and use Brick Oven's convenient drive-thru window for all your to-go orders. It's a matter of taste at Brick Oven Pizza Company in Mountain Home. Get the only mower with suspension technology at Mower Warehouse in Mountain Home, where they accept mower trade-ins, have flexible financing options, and services all brands and models. That's Mower Warehouse, located on Buzzard Roost in Mountain Home.
When I grow up, I want to save lives, like a superhero, and show up when people needed me.
When I grow up, I want to do animations. I want to create characters that can fly.
No matter what it is you want out of life, there is a path to get there.
When I grow up, I don't know what I want to do when I grow up, but I know I want to go to college.
Arkansas State University, Mountain Home. Take your first step at asumh.edu.
Hi, it's Bob Zdora, the Z-Team, Century 21 LeMac Realty, 1024 Highway 62 East in Mountain Home. As you know, we are all facing some unusual times. Be calm. Be smart. The business world of real estate will continue. We may have some delays and some changes that are out of our control, but life will go on, and this too will pass. Give thanks for this wonderful country that we live in. Give thanks for the neighbors that we share. If there's anything we can do to give you a hand, give us a call, 870-405-0793.
And check out our website, retiredtoarkansas.net.
Have you ever?
.752, finishing out the program with Ethan and Sarah Forhetz, and you'll recognize them from KY3 News, Step Out on Faith, working for Convoy of Hope. Tell us about that, taking that leap of faith. I mean, you've both been professional journalists for many years. You were at KMOX TV Channel 4, but you're at KMOV.
Right. KMOV TV in St. Louis. Right.
I remember when KSDK was KSD Channel 5.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Right. Yeah. I grew up with that.
Yeah.
I was there for a couple of years. I worked in Las Vegas for a few years, Tallahassee, Florida, Grand Rapids, Michigan, and eventually to Springfield, where I met the lovely Sarah.
His better half. It was a step of faith. I mean, that's exactly what it was. We felt a stirring from the Lord that change was coming. We're kind of uncertain what that meant exactly, because we are contractual employees. And so we just kept thinking, well, we have at least 18 months before there's going to be any change, because, you know, you have 100% full intentions of fulfilling your contractual obligation.
Now, was that at Channel 3 or with Convoy?
Yeah, at Channel 3.
Channel 3, yeah.
And so I was kind of perplexed when I felt like the Lord was saying, like, get ready, you know, and I was like, okay, we'll get ready, but we have 18 months, Lord. And, you know, He's the God of the covenant, not the contract. And lo and behold, when He says go, even if it's unexpected, you go. And so, it was interesting because really just the last year, I mean, he started to feel that same stirring, and I was very much like, maybe it's me and not you, or maybe it's both of us, or maybe it's just you. I mean, because I realized there's no guarantee that we will always work together, you know? So really just hearing from the Lord individually, I mean, as a couple, yes, but also individually, to make sure that it was the time for both of us to go. So it was a journey.
It was a journey. It was a tough thing to come to, because I had been in television for 25 years, and I thought, Well, and I knew that I was at a great television station, the highest rated NBC affiliate in the country, which is pretty nice.
I think they hold like 83% of the viewing audience.
Oh, it's incredible.
Even here.
It's a powerhouse station. So my dream had come true. I have a great family in a great city at a great TV station. I was living the life, right? Everything was great. And it was. But then I just felt, like Sara said, this stirring, like change is coming. And I thought, well, this is what I wanted to do. I'm going to retire here. You know what I mean?
Yeah. He's the next Ned Reynolds.
I'm going to be Ned Reynolds. That's right.
I don't know about that.
Well, Steve Grant's right behind, because I remember when he was a rookie.
Yeah. Steve, you know, he's lived his life on KY3, and people love him, and as they should. He's great. But that's what I thought was my life. And, you know, when the Lord directs your steps, many are the plans of a man, but the Lord directs your steps, right? We listened to the call, and we're a Convoy now, and it's the more we meet the people on a daily basis, the more impressed we are with the organization, honestly.
And the reason for inviting Ethan Sara here, number one, we need to raise some money, help Convoy of Hope. If you can we pull this up, Scooter?
Yeah.
Okay, on the computer here, we got Convoy of Hope. Here's your donate button right here. You know, any amount helps.
Absolutely.
Any amount helps.
Absolutely. We can put all of it to good use. And, you know, some people sometimes think that, well, I don't have much to give. But, you know, when you partner with us, then now you're involved.
Yeah. Well, and you go back to, you know, Mother Teresa, which Ethan was telling the story about Hal. But everybody can do something. I mean, if it's $1, literally $1 at Convoy turns into about $10 because of the partnerships that we have with corporations. And I mean, truly, I feel like there is such value, scriptural, biblical value, in understanding that we are called to give.
Yes.
You know,
and my theory is
care for the poor and the orphan.
We're all blessed. We're all blessed.
Do you want 10 people giving 100 or 100 people giving 10?
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
Give us 100 giving 10.
501c3.
Yes.
We need to know that.
I mean, absolutely.
Yeah.
It's the big hitters that are looking for places to say, yeah, I can do some good and not hurt myself either.
Right.
No,
exactly.
Absolutely. Yep. Yeah. And, you know, the work we do is tangible. The 200 million meals we supplied
during COVID.
Oh, my goodness.
The vast majority in America, by the way.
Yeah. Most of those meals in America, 200 million meals. It started out as 10 million as a dream. They quickly got to that. And then, okay, well, let's do 50. Got to that. Well, let's do 100. More than 200 million meals we gave away in 2020.
So you need to tell them, don't be shy with this stuff. You need to get the word out, because that's how the word gets spread. And you need to let people know this is what we're doing, and you can be a part of that. That's very important for people to know, because otherwise, like, well, I'll go to this charity or that charity.
Sure.
You want it to
come
to you. Because the good that is done.
ConvoyofHope.org is the website.
And you know the heart of Convoy of Hope. It's a faith-based organization. Yeah. So everything we do is because of what this book says.
You bet.
So that's the reason behind everything that we do.
Wow. And I want to encourage local churches here in the North Central Arkansas area to get involved with Convoy of Hope. You've heard what Ethan and Sara have said about this. And then I want to take the opportunity. You can't see him on camera, but our owner, Gil Reynolds, is over here. And I want to thank him for this opportunity. To be able to bring in folks like Ethan and Sara, talk about faith-based organizations. You know, we've got, real quick, we're down to 2 minutes before we end the show, but how rural we are between here in Calico, here in Marshall, and across the state line of Missouri, there's a lot of folks that we don't know could be in need.
Oh, sure. And that's a great example of, you know, the churches, because you need that infrastructure.
Yes.
If there's an emergency, you need the infrastructure to be able to come in. You guys bring the supplies,
right.
You need the people to be able to take care of the business from there.
Right.
So that's why it's important for the churches to get organized.
That prevents us from having to hire a giant staff to do the giveaways,
right?
We have the volunteers to do it.
Right.
That's why it works.
We got about a minute and a half final thoughts. Thank you for being this is the height of my TV career.
Oh, well, thank you.
I'm sorry about that.
Now, if Mick Jagger and Paul McCartney walk in,
Well, hey, listen, we appreciate, we were talking about during the break that this is what it's supposed to be. This is what local is supposed to be, yeah. Right? It's
we
local
just want
folks.
To be ourselves.
Yeah, being yourself, and your finger is on the pulse of your community, as it should be. You know what the people care about, and you have a way of getting them that information. So thank you for doing what you do here. We appreciate it, and we appreciate being able to talk to our viewers. We feel at home with the lights and the camera. we haven't felt quite as home in a while, so this is nice.
And then Scooter, you can't see Scooter. He's directing over here, and then, of course, Gil Reynolds, Reynolds Media, for the opportunity to bring down on the corner and situations like this with Ethan and Sara, you know, just I was impressed when I watched the news that night when you resigned. I'm running out of time, so I'll go wrap this up. But very honored to have you all here, and I want to raise some awareness for Convoy of Hope.
Thank
I got
you.
About 10 seconds to say
thank
goodbye.
You. Thank you. Yes, thanks
for joining
for
us. See you tomorrow.